Next, we will visualize our files in the Integrative Genomics Viewer, or IGV. This visualization tool will allow us to identify the transcription factor binding site and will illustrate whether surrounding genes are up or down regulated as a result. Launch IGV in the GenomeSpace UI. When this instance of IGV has downloaded, double-click, then select Run on the pop-up menu. If it isn't already selected, be sure to select the mouse MM9 reference genome. To upload our files from GenomeSpace, select GenomeSpace in the toolbar, then Load File from GenomeSpace. Navigate to the appropriate folder. We will start by loading the wild-type gene expression data. Note, you will repeat these steps for the remaining files, but for the sake of this demonstration, we have skipped over these repetitive steps. Start by moving the narrow peaks track by clicking and dragging it to the third track slot. Then, change the color of the top track by right-clicking the wild-type gene expression track, selecting Change Track Color Positive, and selecting the desired color. Next, highlight both gene expression tracks and right-click, change their track heights to 150. Then, highlight all three max output files and right-click, change their tracks to 60. And finally, change the track of the mouse reference genome to 60. Next, we will want to auto-scale all peak files and gene expression files to better interpret this data. Do this by highlighting each track and right-clicking, then select Group Auto-Scale. For the sake of demonstration, we will observe a region on chromosome 7 that illustrates the differential gene expression of the gene IGF2, a gene known to promote the growth and proliferation of cells. In the top two tracks, you can already identify the differential expression between samples. In the third track, you can see its corresponding transcription factor binding site. To observe the peaks within both samples, the wild type and the knockout, and the transcription factor binding site, continue to scroll left and zoom in. At this magnification, we can observe the differing peak pileup between samples and the peak of the transcription factor binding site. Be sure to record this locus region for later use. Now, input the original region locus to observe how this binding event has regulated the IGF2 gene. Just as was done before, continue to zoom and scroll until both gene expression tracks are in the desired layout. Then, highlight both expression tracks, right-click, and select Overlay Tracks. This will better illustrate the differing gene expression between samples. Input the recorded locus region from the binding site before the current locus region in the text box. Then hit the spacebar and select Go. This will create a split screen, allowing us to see the binding site and gene expression in one frame. With the wild type in red and the knockout in blue, we can see that the binding of the PrEP1 transcription factor results in an upregulation of this gene's expression.